Hi, do you have a problem understanding insulin resistance? If so, I am here to explain it to you in a very, very easy way. And if you are wondering why you cannot lose weight even though you are constantly on a diet, please make sure you stick till the end of the video because I will be talking about it. Insulin resistance is connected to many, many diseases. Many of these diseases might be a cause of insulin resistance, or many of them might be effect of insulin resistance. Now, some of these diseases include obesity, heart disease, high cholesterol, Alzheimer's, that is also called type 3 diabetes sometimes, PCOS, high blood pressure, thyroid conditions, fatty liver, breast, endometrial and other cancers, and non-alcoholic liver disease. Now, what is insulin? Insulin is a hormone that helps you store glucose in your fat cells as fat, but also the hormone that delivers glucose inside of your cells and let them create energy. Now, who has the higher risk for developing insulin resistance? First of all, is many of us women with PCOS. Everybody that has diet that is really high in carbohydrates, everybody who has BMI higher than 29, if you have family history of diabetes or gestational diabetes, if you have a sedentary lifestyle, some antidepressants might also cause insulin resistance, as well as some steroid medication. What is more, some negative emotions like stress and anger might also be the cause of insulin resistance because they create a chemical reaction in our body that can cause insulin resistance. Now, on this playlist, you will find a video that will be talking about how to reverse your insulin resistance, as well as video about my story and my journey to reversing insulin resistance. So make sure you click on the playlist and subscribe to this channel. Now, let's get into how does it really work.
If we look at our entire digestion, there are a few basic things we need to know. We have three types of macronutrients that are being digested. First are carbohydrates, called usually carbs. Their digestion starts in our mouth with saliva. Majority of carb digestion happens with help of pancreas. Then we have fats. To digest them, we need our detergent, bile that comes from our liver and gallbladder. However, pancreas still needs to create enzyme lipase to aid digesting fat. Then we have our protein. Protein's digestion starts in our stomach when they are separated to amino acids. We yet again need enzyme from pancreas. So pancreas is very important in digestion and its heaviest load are carbs. Now, when we have too high levels of food rich in carbohydrates, this is going to happen. Of course, it can happen due to earlier discussed reasons, but let's talk about food as an example. We have more food that we need. So we need to store our extra fuel in fat cells. Cells have a little lock called insulin receptor and key called insulin. Insulin opens the gate and extra energy comes in to be stored. Now, we still have too much food coming in and more insulin, so our fat cells are growing. Unfortunately, when it grows and grows, the lock changes and insulin cannot go in anymore. Now let's go back a bit. So our pancreas created glucose, then went to circulate to bloodstream. Then pancreas had to create enough insulin. But what happens in our energy-creating muscle cells? In a healthy person, key and lock fit together. So glucose comes in and we have energy. What happened in case of this other person though? The insulin doesn't open the lock, so glucose cannot go inside and create energy. So the person, even though they ate a lot, are hungry. But what if they ate just a little bit? Well, the energy cannot go into the cell, right? So it goes somewhere else. Maybe creates new fat cells, maybe gets stored in the liver, maybe gets excreted and starts showing more and more diabetes symptoms. So you might be eating very little or very much and still starve and never lose fat because your body can't open the gate with insulin anymore.
So that's it. And as you can see, if you have ever been on very, very low calorie diet, like 1,500 calories or even 1,200 calorie diets, and you still cannot lose weight, it might be because of your high insulin levels. Every time we eat, our body is creating a little bit of insulin. So if you still are in the state of high insulin level, your cells will still be starving, but you will still gain fat. So what might happen is your body will feel like it's starving, you will have no energy, and yet, even though you eat very little calories, you will still be gaining weight. Because the glucose that creates energy is not getting into your muscles, but it is getting into your fat cells. So in turn, very, very often for people with insulin resistance, with people with PCOS and other conditions, it ends up in binge eating, it ends up with distorted eating, it ends up with extreme sugar cravings and so on. So this is why this is so important. If you want to lose weight or just control other symptoms of insulin resistance, it is so important to control your insulin levels. But make sure you like this video, subscribe and click the notification bell so you're notified about the new videos, and make sure you follow this playlist as well, because I will be talking all about insulin resistance. Thank you and see you next time.